You don't have to be sitting in a classroom to learn about things. You can have fun and enjoy learning by using things like the arts, using puppetry and music and dance and all of that type of thing. I found it that it was really effective, that it was like watching a movie without being in a picture theatre, and it was live, so it had an exciting sort of element to it, and it wasn't actors, it was a thing making a story, like a book that made itself work.
Which is in South Africa, and they are surrounded by animals, elephants, rhinoceroses.
Well, I think that often happens in the creative process, that we have an idea and then we collaborate with other hopefully creative people. And I think Gary's idea of Hanush and his friends was fantastic. I think I could see a little bit of a dilemma in terms of that these students don't really have that same problem in their lives, but what we really want for them as educators is for them to be able to empathise and to value the freedom that they've got. Hence, we have been trying to research through our reading and through our talking and listening what those stories are and what's happening around the world at the moment. And I think Hanush's story is a beautiful story in many ways, and obviously a very sad story. And with this particular class, some of them had the background to that story, but many of them didn't have that. So in terms of the future of this particular project, it would be valuable for the students to have read, be widely read. So wide reading, of course, is very important. In the real world, we have students who don't necessarily read avidly. We do have some, but what I feel was important in this was that if one student was familiar with a story and had the history behind them, then they were communicating that to others. And sometimes it was passing that story along by retelling, not necessarily reading. So there has been a lot of talking going on in this project, and I think for students that is so important, especially in a day and age where you're getting many students coming to school without the language that we would hope them to have, without that facility. And I've been increasingly thrilled with what this class have been able to do. I believe these types of activities, so that the stimulus with Hanush and his friends and then the whole package, I suppose, of what we've done has helped so many students demonstrate their gifts and talents, mm-hmm. which they may not have been able to do in a more narrow dimension.
Well, I did Nelson Mandela. He stood up for what he believed in, and he led other people to feel the same about their worth.
And how did he do that?
Well, he did charity for HIV/AIDS, and he was in jail for 27 years.
I wrote about Mahatma Gandhi, and he is a very famous Indian man. And he was around when, just after the British colonists came into India and wanted to take over India.
My one's Mark Zuckerberg.
And
Mark Zuckerberg, yeah?
Yeah. And he wanted to make something where everybody could connect and everybody could, like, write about things, and if someone's in China and someone's in Australia, they could talk to each other without having to send letters. So he created the Facebook.
There's lots of different ways that I saw today. Some were retelling tales of great people who did great things, like Nelson Mandela and Jean Robert McLean. And some were also showing how people, just normal everyday people, can do things to help the world. So, yeah, I thought it was really amazing how they all put it together.
The whole school should get this opportunity because it's so inspirational and you learn so much. Like, I didn't even know about shadow puppets until Gary taught us about them. And watching Gary do puppets, like, and making them, it's so great because you can make anything up. You can do your own thing. So, and you get to make up your own stories and you get to make the characters, and there's usually a narrator, and everyone has a really good time because everyone can pretty much make their own characters and make what they want them to look like.
It was actually really amazing how you can do all these different things and make shadow puppets advanced and all that, and it was just really good. And my group did history on Nelson Mandela, but we did in shadow puppet form. And it was really good how we did all these effects, like the jail and the background. And it was just really fun to do.
Some of them used the storyboard ideas and the narratives, adding the music, etc., really, really well. Others need to develop on those skills a bit more. We're actually going to follow through with another filmmaking process next term. Not with shadow puppets, but with clay. But I thought overall that they now understand the whole concept of telling a story. Seeing the other classes, the other class did more of a retelling. Ours, well, the direction that my class had was to create your own story. So they had, each person was being a particular character. Whereas with the other class, it was more of a narrator and a narrated known story. So the direction was different.
We got to witness this morning the first-hand dress rehearsal type activity. We saw the children perform an activity which was absolutely wonderful in its raw state. And of course, then we saw the finished products that the children had put together. Having such a project like this at Kirkhill North, we believe that the creative arts are really important. We believe that the creative arts supports literacy and learning, and we're fortunate that one of our teachers, Janelle Warhurst, went off and put in a submission and a grant. And as I said this morning, the idea started with Jan and Gary, and then Mayling Travis came on board, and of course then the students in those grades. To see the culmination this morning, I was blown away. It was absolutely amazing. Gary did some wonderful editing for us, but the time that's been involved working with the children is not just a matter of getting up there and putting a puppet show together, making some little black cutouts. The kids took the time. They researched their stories. They discussed it. They then had to break it down and bring it into a workable sort of size. I've seen them doing that, and the engagement that they've had, the level of learning, the involvement has been absolutely superb. And for them to actually witness, and we had kindergarten children here this morning, we had year one children, year two, children right across the grade, you know, you could have heard a pin drop at certain times in the audience. Obviously, some of the concepts were higher and above the level of thinking than the early stage one and stage one children. However, the children in year six were able to bring it down also in their filming. The discussion after, you know, the children were leaving the hall and I spoke to children outside, and the discussion continued through the part of the playground into the school, back to their classes, and that shows that it was powerful in itself, Gary. Mm-hmm. And you know, we're just delighted to have been involved as a school.